Jon and I have been working together for about 10 years trying to better understand how teams work together to do engineering design.
Studying first, how do we model how humans solve design problems, hard problems computationally? How do we create agents that can imitate and mimic that behavior? We were able to show that we can actually do that. We can capture the cognitive processes of humans into agents, put them in teams, and show that those teams can perform just like those humans in terms of how they solve design problems.
More recently, we've gotten really excited about the potential of AI to support teams in doing what they do even better. So we've started to look at what we call human-AI hybrid teams.
One way of us doing this is by having the agents as a tool that the humans call. So the humans call the AI and ask it to solve some problems for it.
We've looked at AI as a partner, really engaging as a teammate with the rest of the team to do problem solving.
And we were able to show that having that AI as a partner that's proactively solving part of the problem improves problem performance for the overall team.
And we've looked at AI as a manager, an agent in the team that can help guide the more general process that the team is going through.
Our question was, could we create an AI agent that can do the same thing? And as a matter of fact, we did. We have an agent that's able to watch in real time humans solving these hard problems, and when it senses problems, it intervenes and nudges the team so that it goes back on track. And it performs just as well as a human, and even at times marginally better than the human manager. That's even true when the problem changes a little bit and the team has to adjust. And even though the AI wasn't trained on that new problem, it's still able to adjust the team, and the team performs really, really well.
But in some cases, when we have an AI, even a high-performing AI, working with a team on a challenging engineering design problem, the overall effectiveness of the team can decrease. So understanding that interaction between the human and AI sides of the team is really essential for making sure that we can design hybrid teams that really get the best from both worlds.
Our goal is to first understand how it changes design of humans, and then secondly, how do we create AI agents that actually make design more effective and improve the process. And so the impact of this really will be informing that entire new generation of AI design agents.
We've shown that when AIs and humans work together, human members of the team are enabled and freed up to focus on more high-value tasks in the design process. Things like better understanding the problem, sense-making, or managing information. As we've been developing these state-of-the-art AIs that engage in engineering design in various ways and examining how they interact with people and teams in that process to design and operate a small drone delivery business. So in that team, we have a few different roles. So it's what we would call a heterogeneous team or a team with multiple specialties. So we have agents or members of the team that focus on designing the drones themselves. We have members of the team that focus on operations and routing, figuring out which drone should go where. We have business managers who focus on understanding the business case and managing profit. And we also have process managers, managers that guide the overall process of the team. And we designed this platform, which we call Highform, from the ground up as a research test bed. And that's been really exciting, because it allows us to capture a lot of information from the people who take part in our experiments, and that allows us to make really robust analyses and insights about the interaction that's going on. So I think of this as early stage research, where we're understanding some of the boundaries and the limits, but also the opportunities.
But I think that you'll start to see more and more of the impact of this work over the next, say, 5 years. Carnegie Mellon's a very unique place, and that collaboration is really inherent to what we do. Working with Chris has been an exciting and rewarding experience for the last 10 years. And the kind of work that we've done, I don't think we could do anywhere else. Carnegie Mellon is very unique in terms of collaboration being so deep-rooted in terms of the type of work that's done. But even AI and machine learning is so prevalent in mechanical engineering today at Carnegie Mellon that the environment is ripe for this type of collaboration.